We're back on the Common Sense Club on the Scott Hannon Show. Countdown to caucus day in Minnesota. If folks gather tonight, the election night party for our next guest is in Minnesota. What does that tell you? Ron Paul is back with us on the Common Sense Club and the Scott Hannon Show. Mr. Congressman, nice to have you back. How are you?
Thank you. Doing well.
Well, first of all, you ought to get a medal, and I'm glad that your fellow candidates in this battle for the GOP nomination do seem to recognize what you bring to the debate, the discussion, the conversation in this country about liberty and economic freedom, and it seems as though, given the financial condition we're in this country, that message is resonating, and as much with your fellow candidates as with folks around the country. Do you feel like you moved the ball a little bit in this campaign?
Absolutely, and it's been gradual. Of course, I've been trying to do this at least for a lot of years. There's been a definite difference in the last 4 years. After the last campaign and then the financial crunch came, it built a lot of credibility for us who have been arguing this case, and the free market economists have been worried about the conditions that we were working on. But in the last 6 months, there's been a dramatic difference, too. And it's been steady. If you'd have asked me 5 years ago whether there would be a whole generation of young people who are yelling and screaming to look at the Fed and not at the Fed and end the Fed, I'd have never believed it. So there's definitely a different discussion going on. Even the other candidates, I think, are being more respectful. They don't think it's to their political advantage to attack us who believe in the Constitution and very little government.
Are you in this to win the nomination, or is this winning the battle of ideas and advancing your noble cause on expanding liberty?
Well, I don't think the two are incompatible. We're always in to win. And then when I first started running in Congress, it was, you know, the same old story. I was in to win. I didn't think I would. But you have to be in it to win. You have to do your very best. You have to get the most amount of delegates possible. But that doesn't mean that you can't achieve something if you don't happen to come in first place. And nobody knows exactly what the future will bring. Some of these candidates have come and gone, and they get into trouble, and all of a sudden they crash into polls. So it's not like it's impossible, but the reality is that Romney is, you know, well ahead of the other candidates. But we're slowly and steadily accumulating a lot of delegates, and some of these straw votes don't tell the whole story because the delegate selection takes several months to actually be accomplished.
How badly do you need a win? And is possibly your first win a few hours away in Minnesota, given you've planned an election night party for here? I mean, do you have to win a state to say, hey, Ron Paul's won one and in the sweepstakes as well? And do you see that being Minnesota tonight?
Well, let's hope so. I don't know. I think you really need to. You can hardly get enough delegates if you don't start winning some. But that remains to be seen. But in the meantime, the main goal is to keep plugging along, keep building. Our numbers keep growing, you know, and the market works pretty well. You know, if you don't get volunteers, you don't get phone callers, and you don't get the money to come in, you know, that's another message that you have. But right now, the enthusiasm isn't, disappearing. It's actually building. So I guess we're going to be in it for a while.
The GOP rules are written that really are at odds with the idea of winner-take-all. Clearly, in the black and white of the rules, I know national committeeman, one from North Dakota, Curly Hoglund, who insists the more the candidates remain in this race, the more that the brokered convention is a reality. Do you see yourself staying in through the convention, and do you agree with that the rules favor more candidates being in and ultimately settling this at the convention?
Yeah, I think so. I think it's a fairer system that you don't have winner take all. I mean, that was one of the reasons we didn't invest millions of dollars that we couldn't afford to go into Florida. I mean, the polls were against us. There was a huge amount of money in there. We could have spent $10-15 million. We probably could have raised that for that, but the odds of coming out with anything were slim. It's much better to come to Minnesota and put in an effort with a lot less money and target the people, and you can become more competitive. So we can compete with these tens of millions of dollars that the other candidates have.
Mitt Romney told us yesterday that if this primary battle drags out into the convention, that it hurts the GOP in the long run because Obama, ultimately will then have much more money and the GOP will be wildly outspent, saying at some point we'll have to pick our person and start raising money so we can compete with Barack Obama. Otherwise, we'll be, quote, massively outspent. Disagree with that?
Well, there's a little bit of truth to that. Of course, with his financial statement, I don't know whether he'd worry too much. But, you know, that's what they were saying, you know, when Obama and Hillary were running against each other. But, you know, as soon as the nomination was over, they seemed to come together and they raised enough money. Obama ended up raising more money than anybody else ever raised. So I don't know if that's an absolute at all, what he's saying.
There's a Washington Post story today that suggests there's a strategic alliance between you and Mitt Romney not to attack each other. Is that true?
Not exactly. I mean, I never sat down with Mitt and said, well, let's do this or that. There's no doubt that he's been, you know, more of a gentleman when I talk to him. And it's never been in my interest to go after him. Everybody else was doing that. As a matter of fact, I don't even like that part of politics. But then on the other side is we did some ads where we, you know, called him a flip-flopper and things like that. But there's nothing strategic. I mean, there's been no decision. The staffs have talked to each other on some of the things like debates and which debates we would go to, but nothing where because we I don't know of how many things that we have a strong agreement on. You know, our foreign policies are different, and he's certainly not attacking the Federal Reserve and his record up in Massachusetts wasn't anything I could, you know, get too enthusiastic about. But I would say the most important thing is he's somebody I can talk to, and I sort of like that approach in everything I do.
I talked to your son in New Hampshire, Senator Rand Paul, about the campaign, and he said one of the things he was very frustrated about is he thought you were horribly misunderstood on foreign policy. For instance, Iran or future conflicts, saying basically you're not against war, you're against how we go to war, and that ultimately if Congress says go to war, for instance, against Iran or anybody else, then you'd be 100% for it. Is he right? Are you misunderstood on foreign policy?
Well, absolutely, because that is true. I want to fool off all the rule of law. I detest the fact that presidents can take us to war without a declaration, and we get into too many wars that way. And besides, it's a big money issue, too. You know, look at all the money we've spent, $4 trillion of additional debt in these last 10 years. So I just think that this whole thing, one thing that they use against me that is a misconstruing what I believe in is, you know, they throw out the word isolation. And yet the founders talked about this. They didn't want to be isolationists, but they wanted to trade with people, talk to people, negotiate with people, be friends with people. That's what their advice was. We have no authority to get involved in these wars. Right now, we're on the verge. I'm sure we're very much involved behind the scenes in Syria right now. And now our involvement there and our determination to overthrow that government. The civil war's been going on a year. Now the Russians are in there. You know, that's the
we're gonna have to leave it there. Congressman Ron Paul, thanks for your time today.